January 2019 saw the passing of the DNA Technology Use and Application Regulatory Bill 2019 in the Lok Sabha. It provides for the regulation of use and application of DNA technology for the purposes of establishing the identity of certain categories of persons, including the victims, offenders, suspects under trials, missing persons, and unknown deceased persons, and for matters connected. It was referred to the Parliamentary Standing Committee, which after few extensions have given several inputs and apprehensions, with privacy and its misuse as being among the core issues. Other issues revolve around the privacy of citizens, concerned with civil liberties, ethical and other social implications, and professional ethics in DNA profiling. DNA Regulatory Board, consisting of 12 members, DNA labs to be set up across the country, and DNA data bank that will be set up at central level or regional level with every state or two or more state. The main functions of regulatory body is to advise the central and state government on all issues relating to the establishment of DNA labs and DNA data banks, and all laying down guidelines, standards and procedures for establishing and functioning of such labs and data banks. It will also grant accreditation or suspend or revoke such accreditation to the labs for undertaking DNA testing and analyzing. It will also assist in criminal investigation between various investigative agencies within the country and outside any country. It will also make recommendations to the central government for the application of privacy protection in relation to the access to or the use of DNA samples and their analysis. DNA labs cannot function without accreditation by DNA regulatory board, so it is obliged to follow the standards and procedures for quality assurance in the collection, storage, testing and analyzing of DNA samples. It will also establish and maintain such documentation and quality system, and prepare and maintain quality manuals containing such details. It will share the data with DNA data bank. DNA data bank shall maintain the various categories of data, namely a crime science scene index, a suspect index or under trial index, an offenders index, a missing persons index, and unknown deceased person index. Written consent is mandatory for obtaining bodily substances for DNA profiling in case of any offense other than unspecified offenses. These specified offenses means any offense punishable with death or imprisonment for a term exceeding 7 years. In case of refusal of consent, the investigating officer can approach magistrate. If someone wants to volunteer who was present at the scene of crime when it was committed, or is being questioned in connection with the investigating of a crime, or intends to find the whereabouts of his missing or lost relatives in disaster or otherwise, can voluntarily consent in writing to bodily substance being taken from him for DNA testing. In case of persons below age of 18 years and physically handicapped persons, consent of parents or guardians is necessary. And if it is refused or cannot be obtained, investigative officer may apply to magistrate. Sample of DNA testing will be collected from bodily substances, scene of occurrence or scene of crime, clothing and other objects, and such other sources as may be specified by regulation. Manner of collection of samples for intimate and non-intimate bodily substances has been given. Information will be secured and confidentially kept with the national or regional data bank or labs or any other person or authority under the Act. These information will be used only for the purpose of facilitating identification of persons and not any other purpose. But If the director of data bank considers appropriate to provide data for the sole purpose of proper operation and maintenance of a data bank or training purposes, it can provide data to the concerned persons or DNA labs. One-time keyboard search is also made available. This will be some restrictions on data of crime scene, index of DNA profile derived from bodily substances of victim of offense, or a person who has been suspended as a suspect in relevant investigation. There are prohibition on access to information in DNA data bank. The DNA labs, after deriving the DNA profile and depositing it with the DNA data bank, shall return the biological sample or remaining material for its preservation to the investigating officer in a criminal case till the disposal of the case or the order of the court, and in all other cases destroy the biological sample or remaining material and intimate the persons concerned. The funding of this whole project will come from central government, which will be audited by CAG. Offenses and penalties in form of imprisonment extending up to 2 to 3 years and fine extending up to 50,000 to 1 lakh rupees is imposed. In some cases, if central government is of the opinion of superseding the regulatory board, it can do so, but not exceeding 6 months. Central government will also have greater power in terms of directions to be given to the board or in case of any kind of conflict. No court shall have a jurisdiction to entertain any suit or proceedings in respect of any matter which the board is empowered by or under this act to determine. There is list of matters for DNA testing. Suggest its use in offences under IPC, ITP, MTP, prohibition in sex selection, domestic violence, civil rights, SCST, atrocity prohibition, motor vehicles and several civil dispute acts.